got the man who's after that Bofors case, Ajay, who's along Ajay with Agarwal. Parikshit Luthra. Yeah. Over to you, Parikshit. Ajay Agarwal, yes.
Yes, Ritham, hectic developments taking place here at Supreme Court. Mr. Ajay Agarwal, you're a member of the BJP, you're a petitioner in the Bofors case. This has come as a setback for the Congress party because it seemed through the hearing that the Supreme Court felt that now they're overdoing it.
No, in fact, the Supreme Court said that we have already appointed the pro tem speaker on your suggestion. Mm. We have given the power to conduct the floor test on your suggestion. Mm. Now, how can we change at this point of time? How can we order without hearing the party, without hearing the speaker, Mr. Bopayya? Yeah. How can we change him now?
There's no possibility. This point that was made by the additional Solicitor General that there will be a live telecast of the entire proceedings, that was the clincher. And after that, there was really no argument left.
Yes, after the hearing, sometime when the hearing took place, regarding convention, etc., also that the senior most person be appointed as the speaker and all that. Then Mr. Tushar Mehta, who is ASG appearing for the governor, he said the speaker has already taken a decision and the entire proceeding of the floor test will be telecasted live on the regional channels.
Don't you also feel that this entire episode has been embarrassing for the BJP as well, embarrassing for the image of the party?
No, there is no question why, because the speaker has already taken
the events over the last few days.
Himself, he has taken a decision.
The fact that the trust force was preponed, was asked to be done in 24 hours itself.
Many times it has happened. Supreme Court has taken a decision many times for a preponing of this floor test because some parties, they cast aspersions on the others. Okay. So there is nothing wrong if the Supreme Court has preponed it and the BJP has welcomed it also. Right. And the speaker has taken the decision on its own. To conduct the floor test under live telecast.
Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Agarwal, for joining us.
I said also that all channels may telecast it, and the Secretary General of the Assembly will record it also.
Okay, thank you for speaking to us, Mr. Agarwal. Nalini is also standing by. I'm going to get in a quick word from Nalini, who was inside the Supreme Court. Nalini, that was a dramatic hearing, a short hearing. Give us a sense of the body language, the atmosphere in court. Was it as packed as yesterday? What did you hear? What were the clinching arguments?
Well, it was very interesting what's happened because at the end of the hearing, all of the Congress's plea that they had in fact brought before the court had become infructuous, hence they were rejected, because once Tushar Mehta actually made the statement that the entire floor test is going to be live telecasted on all the local channels, of course it put things into perspective. It removed all the doubt from the judge's mind to such an extent that Justice Sikri, who was leading the bench, actually told Tushar Mehta, we thank you for putting forth this statement because this has solved all our problems and now we don't need to conduct this hearing, because that was the solution that they were looking for, because all they wanted was a fair and unbiased floor test to happen.
Do you feel that the Congress was embarrassed to some extent because the judges said that you wanted a pro tem speaker to be appointed, we've done exactly what you wanted, and now if you cast aspersions, we'll have to call him, we'll have to delay the floor test, and this would go against what you wanted and we'll be going against our own judgment.
Absolutely, Parikshit. Actually, at the end of the day, this entire hearing boiled down to exactly what happened in the previous hearing, whether or not the court can actually go ahead and question a governor's decision when he's taken a decision in his executive capacity. So that's what the judges also realized, that at the end of the day, it's going to go back to that. So that for that, we'll need a detailed hearing. So do you want to postpone the floor test? For which the Congress realized that that's not something that they are ready for. And then the entire solution was given by Tushar Mehta once he said that they're going to live telecast the entire floor test.
All right. Thanks, Nani, for joining us. Ritham, it's over to you. Dramatic hearing in the Supreme Court, and even now, just take a look at the buzz. I'm going to quickly just pan around our cameras, show you the kind of atmosphere, the kind of security that is around in the Supreme Court, and back to you.